Okay, you guys, so to depot your eyeshadows into like any of these MAC palettes. Okay, so I'm just gonna let it heat up for a second, and while it does that, I'll show you guys how to actually take the shadows and how to take the pans out. Okay. So all of these shadows, when you open them, they are all going to have, I don't know if you can see that here, there's this little part right here, right in between where the latch is. You can actually see like a little indent right in there. Okay, so take your knife, be careful if you're under 18, please get your parents to help you do this. Knife or tweezers. Again, I prefer my tweezers. Okay, so I'm gonna hold it like that, and I'm just going to keep twisting until I can get my tweezers in. So now my tweezers are inside the actual shadow, as you can see. Okay, so now I can just move it side to side, and this is the part where you have to kind of be careful because your shadows will pop out like that. So basically, now you have this part. So this is Naked Lunch that I just did. So now that you just have this, okay, this portion does not have to be returned to MAC if you do the back to MAC program. But basically, this is the part that you're going to be placing onto your flat iron. Okay, and then we are going to remove the metal pan that's inside this plastic black holder. The flat iron, you're just going to lay it flat like this. Whatever surface you're working on that towel. Okay, you're going to take your parchment paper or wax paper and place it directly on there. And you're going to carefully take your shadow and you're just going to place it directly on the iron. And you're going to wait a couple minutes. I usually wait about 6 to 7 minutes on 330 degree setting. And then you should be ready to continue. So I'm just gonna let this sit until the plastic is actually workable, and we'll be right back. So I checked back after 5 minutes and it actually looks like it was ready. The way you know that it's ready, oops, okay, is, let me just flip, zoom in. When you flip it over, okay, you're going to see that hole right there, and that's actually just the plastic that's melted. So move this aside, and this is the part where you have to be careful. So make sure that it's not too hot for you to handle, okay? And you're going to take your knife or tweezers, and I'm just going to take like the dull end, and I'm just going to push it up. Okay, so I hope you can see this. I'm pushing it up like that. Okay, and you can actually, you can sort of see the pan coming up like that. So that's from you pushing at that plastic. So you want to be ready to catch it. Usually what I do is just on top of the dish towel, okay, like this, I'm just going to push it out that. Can definitely help your shadow. You can go in there and take your tweezers, okay, and then let me just open it up and stick it right in between the metal pan and the plastic, and then just pull it out like that. Okay, and then you're gonna see all that glue. This is the part where you gotta be very, very, very careful. It's super hot. Okay, you just want to flip that metal pan onto your towel. Okay, so there it is. This you can throw away. It does not have to be put back in this and returned to MAC. So this part you can just discard. So recycle whatever it is that you want to do with it. Get rid of it. Okay, and then you're going to have this metal pan, which is extremely hot. do not touch this until it is completely cool. Don't do the finger test to see if it's cool. I just recommend waiting maybe 5 minutes before even attempting to pick it up or removing that glue. The glue is fairly easy to remove. You can remove it either with rubbing alcohol on a Q-tip very carefully so that way the alcohol does not get on your actual shadow. So while this cools, I'm going to do my other one. Okay, so I have my second one departed. I already put my Naked Lunch into the palette, and let me just take it out. Okay, on mine, I went ahead and put the label directly on there. I don't like to place those circular labels on the lid right here, only because if I ever want to change anything out, like, I struggle with it a lot, but I mean, you can. So that's what a lot of people do, is they buy those circular label stickers, and they'll place them on the lid, and then they'll write the names, or you can just remove the original labels and stick them back at the bottom of your pans, so that way you'll just have them, okay? And it just goes in just like that. Okay, so to show you guys how to remove this label, it's kind of hot still. Okay, to remove the labels for rice paper, as you can see right here, I've already removed this one. Okay, so to remove this one, I'm just going to open it. You need a lighter. This part is completely optional. So you grab your lighter, and you're going to hold it like this. Okay, so this hand is going to be your lighter, and then you're going to hold it directly underneath this, but because I'm returning this to MAC, I don't want to ruin this by melting the plastic, so you're just going to use the heat of the lighter, not the actual flame, to melt the glue that's binding this label to the container. Keep it at a good distance. Okay, so here's my lighter. This is as far up as I'm going to be, and I'm going to swirl it around directly on top of the flame. Okay, and you already see it lifting a little bit. I don't know if you can see that. Okay, so we're gonna try it with just that much heat. It needs a little bit more. Okay, so there it is. Okay, you just want to get it so it aligns properly. So, there you have it. I hope you guys found this helpful. Feel free to drop me a line if you guys have any questions, and I will help you as much as possible. Okay, you guys, well, I hope you guys have a good one.